Hello, and welcome back to Epic Mickey. Last time, we learned how to paint and thin stuff, and took on a Swiss Army knife and everything, and this time, we keep on exploring. So let's see what's around here. Yeah, that doesn't do anything. Thought it might. There'll just be a lot of running around and collecting stuff, I expect. Man. Yeah, when seers see you, they call in friends. Hence why their giant eyeballs called seers. Dude. Not cool. Are there any of the other... What the... Don't smack him. He's a buddy. Yeah, one of the seers attacked the other one. Must have not yet realized that I'd befriended it. So yeah, that kind of leads to one of my big complaints about this game, is the combat. I love the idea. You can just spray paint at an enemy and befriend it, or you can spray thinner and kill it. And I think it's really cool that they give you a choice. But painted enemies will attack other ones and eventually kill them. And so you'll get these groups of larger enemies where it's just practically impossible to save them all. Especially since those thin enemies, or those, thinned enemies, those actual enemies just attack the allies and eventually make them enemies again. And suddenly you've got even more enemies and are probably out of paint. It's not so bad now, but it will be later. It's like they can't decide whether or not they want you to be able to befriend things, or if it's like they just want you to create allies just to use them, not to actually save the enemies, which I think is kind of missing the point of why I love doing this. Anyway, you'll notice a lot of things are shiny. They'll have that bit of light that goes across them, and that means you can interact with them, usually by spinning to attack them, but also by doing this. Oh, no, you do actually spin to interact with it. And again. And this is the first time the game has explained to us that they are called gremlins. Yeah, I don't know what's in that chest. Probably just e-tickets. Yeah, so this is the first real instance of a choice other than just combat that the game has given you. You could break this and send him flying, or you can save him and lose the treasure chest. It's pretty obvious which is the painted path and which is the thinner one, you know? Dude, could you, like, show your gratitude by not breaking the catapult? There's sort of a chest I want to, never mind, I guess. Oh, well, we still got something. Yeah, obviously the right thing to do is to save the guy, but it's neat that they give you the choice. And, yeah. No way to access that now. Alright, let's see. Which way? Okay, I guess the other way. Lots of just running around and exploring. 3D platformer stuff. Okay, locked the camera angle. Gee, thank you for explaining something like that, game. I was just about to explain it myself, but if you want to spoil any of the fun of solving a puzzle... it's no big deal. There'll be lots of puzzles later that the game doesn't hold your hand on, if I remember correctly. Where I'll be wishing that Gus would just tell me how to do everything. Yes, guardians. Guardians are important, those little things flying around. How do you know they're drawn to me? They're just not even doing anything. And you've never encountered someone like me. You say I'm unique. Explain yourself, man. You haven't even introduced yourself. Alright. Seriously, though? Alright, yeah. Tints, blue, guardians can be used to befriend enemies. Sometimes it might take more than one to befriend an enemy, I think. And you fill in this little gauge at the top left corner by painting in stuff. And as you paint in more and more stuff, tints are going to show up. Same with, I think they're called terps, the thinner guardians, which I'm sure we will be meeting shortly. I already knew that, thank you. It is pretty satisfying to see all of the stuff that's been thinned out come back as you paint it. Something about that I just like. Yes, game, you don't have to tell me for like the billionth time, or more like the third or whatever, that I can spin by doing this. I mean, come on. I heard you the first time. That's true. Gears and machines are a big deal. But yeah, seriously, I'd forgotten that the game told you how to do everything so much at the beginning. Slightly concerned I was gonna take fall damage or something. Lots of e-tickets. What green guardians? I can't see them. Alright. So yeah. The game basically just rewards you based on how you act. As he said, which is pretty cool. I'm already gonna have to go back down there later, so I'll just leave that. So yeah, I usually get tints by painting things in. The blue guardians, not terps. Oh, right. Hey look, a puzzle where the game didn't explain how to do it. And oh look, another puzzle. Those things just mysteriously completely disappear. Never to appear again. I mean, you'd think that there'd be a bunch of rocks down there, but nope. I'm pretty sure they're just gone forever. Seriously? Come on, Gus. I'm not deaf. Or blind. Ah, projector screens. Those are pretty cool. But yeah, seriously, it is a little bit weird, this game, how it just sort of throws you into the story. I mean, it kind of shows it's gonna have this big, dramatic story at the beginning, and then, like, Mickey's first bit of dialogue is, I have to get home, or whatever. See, my first thing that I'd say would probably be something more like, what was that thing? Who are you? Where am I? Not, I need to get home. I don't know. I'm a little bit surprised that they've done so little explaining about who these characters are and where you are. Aha, thought so. I don't remember how much those are worth and I wasn't paying attention to the counter. Okay, can I make this jump without taking damage? I am skeptical. No. No, I probably can. Okay, that worked. And that's that area done. Oh. Finally, they named a character. It does seem natural for cartoons, yes. So yeah, projector screens are really cool, and they're just how you get from one area to another. So there's just... new quests. They're just, 2D platforming sections, and you can see the awesome bits of film at the end. A lot of them just have an old cartoon feel. Or maybe all of them. I don't remember all of them. And in each of them, there's a film reel, which is a special collectible that you can only get from that specific projector screen. And since you only can go into a projector screen once most of the time, you really want to go through and collect them while you can, because you can turn them in to get prizes later. Naturally, some of them are easier and some of them are harder. Here, you just fall down here, come over, and Mickey and the Beanstalk film reel. So the film reels, I think, always just... Basically, it's... They're supposed to be the cartoon that you were just in, and there is a movie theater that we can turn them into later. That's the neat thing about this game, is the sort of cartoon movie theme. Oh. It's not how you're supposed to do it. Yeah, I like double jumping. I use it a lot in this game. I really was surprised to learn the whole hold down the A button to jump further. And I demonstrate it. And promptly fall. And I think lose health. I won't be doing that again, hopefully. Okay. Well, that took much longer than it should have, so let's just move on. Okay, I will travel to wherever Slalom is. This game is weird, especially for a 3D platformer, in that you just travel to lots of sort of one-off locations that you never revisit. That's how you basically spend the majority of the game. Oh, well, I have paint. I don't throw paint around. I have a brush, not a bucket. So yeah, you can break the middle gear. I have no idea what that does. But obviously I'm not going to, because that would be mean. Again, paint or thinner, good or evil. Oh, whoops. Oh yeah, and so you can, well, I feel kind of bad demonstrating it, but I should show it off. It's a Let's Play. You can thin, and You can thin NPCs. And do that, or... Sorry, dude. You can paint them, and little Mickey Mouse heads will float up, and they will act happier. And it's sort of like they're your friends. And I think that just sort of carries over to later characters if you do it on one of them, but I'm not sure. It doesn't have any practical purpose, I don't think. But it's neat. And see them look a little bit more upbeat. Anyway, go ahead and paint these in. Spatter. Can do. But yeah, you can ignore the steam pipes if you want to, I think. Oh yes, greening paint will come in handy. And you can thin these out again, I guess, but I don't really know what that would do. Anyway, yeah, I think you can just skip these, but it's a quest, so I'm gonna do it. And you get a reward. Let's see. I just noticed, maybe for the first time, that spatters have Mickey Mouse ears, kind of like that proto-blot thing that Mickey was making back in the opening cutscene. Huh. How interesting to think that one of the main types of enemies is modeled to look after Mickey Mouse. Just sort of a reminder that Mickey's the one who ruined the world. You're really not so much working to save the world as you are to just right the wrong that you already did. Or you can make it worse. It's a very interesting concept for a game. Have the hero be the one who created the problem. Interesting. So, Gus, make sure that you have the option to use either paint or thinner. I would think he'd just encourage you to use paint. Anyway. Good thing this paintbrush has good range. Don't really know what thinning that would do beyond just letting you get through. Maybe nothing. Still getting used to the camera controls. And let's just avoid all of those giant gears. Oh, I'm already full on paint. Yeah, the game may be very generous with giving paint out now, but I seem to remember running short a decent number of times later on. Just wishing I had more paint. Thank you, Gus. The next time, could you call it something like a double jump instead of just saying, try using double jump? This sounds a little funny. Eh, it's not so bad. Whoa, that was much closer than I expected it to be. I saw something. Oh, there's something up there. Gonna have to ride this again anyway. What was down here? Just some platforms with a couple of collectibles in case you fall, I guess. But how are you supposed to get back up? Oh, you just ride this. Okay. Oh, not a collectible, just a light bulb. Man. Okay. Oh. Yeah, I think it might be. Yeah, see? He's got, like, little Mickey Mouse ears. And you get a nice remix, I think, of, It's a small, small world or whatever. For the enemy themes. Kinda cool. Anyway. No. Okay. No, I won't. They're my friends. They've got little Mickey Mouse heads floating above them and everything. Anyway, this is probably the reward for patching all those steam pipes. Oh, no, it's just progression. I hope not. That would be, you know, evil. Ah, that would probably be the reward for clearing the... for painting the steam pipes. Yep, thought so. There's usually a reward for something like that. Anyway, anything in here? Nope. Oh well. collecting stuff. Can't do anything with that. Well, can I thin it? Nope. I can just make it turn a sickly shade of green. Which is rather appropriate. Ah, this area. I like this area. This area is cool. How is he trapped? He can teleport. Unless you're telling me that they made their ticket booth out of the same material as the cages. Well, I think we will free him and explore this place in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you then.